Pise aqui! Cascade Hops, you know what I'm saying? Because it's all about the cascade, right? So, I've been reviewing some of these hops. So I'm going to be buying new varieties because I'm kind of sick of the ones I've been getting. And we've all had Cascade enough times that... But whatever. And so, I'm not sure what I'm going to get next, but... I did Bravo, Columbus, Glacier, now this, and I still got Styrene Goldings on me. So I'm going to chew this up. It takes a minute for these flavors and acids, alpha acids, to settle in. So just bear with me for a second here. Okay, well, yeah, we've all had that a million times, but it's really well balanced. It's a really good hop, though. It's only 6.7% alpha acids. I think a lot of people probably think that it's higher than that. But depending what farm you get it from, whatever, it varies a little bit. But these ones are 6.7. Yeah, definitely a grapefruitiness to it. But I don't know if it's the worst for that. That's the one everyone associates with the grapefruit. But I'm not finding it overkill on the grapefruit. There is a lot of kind of spicy, dankier, planty, slightly mossy notes behind it. But the grapefruit's right up front, but there is just a peppery acid burn right on top of that. So that's kind of leading the way, is that acidy peppery burn. And then the grapefruit, like pink grapefruit. And then like peaty, earthy, kind of planty things behind it. But it's very kind of, there's a grapefruit, but it's not exactly 100% grapefruit. There's a little bit of orange there too, maybe a little bit. Like they're, I don't think that it's, I think it's great. And I'm probably gonna dry hop on my last beers that I did with this. Anyway, that's I guess there's a reason everyone's using it. I think this is one of the Columbus. I was really impressed with the Columbus too. So did some brewing today, and went a little odd, but it was successful all the same. I've always been able to hit my efficiencies previous to this. Like, if I wanted to brew a 6%, I always shoot for like 6% or 6.5% beer, whether it's a stout or whatever. And of course, the hydrometer doesn't work when it's hot, so it's hard to tell when you've just sparged. But I ended up going for an 8.5% beer and ended up with a 6. About a little over 6. And I was like, well, that's weird. So I kept sparging the grain bed and then got enough runnings out of that to get about a 3.5% beer. And so I jacked it up with honey, so I'm gonna have a honey ale so as well. So anyway, turned lemons into lemonade there, and then I had enough time that I brewed a little over 2 gallons of mead. So a pretty productive day in brewing. But yeah, so I'll use these hops up and then I'm up for getting some more. So cool. It's not really an overkill hop really either. It's just it's not too overpowering. Even the grapefruit, it's not bothering me. Just even eating that hop pellet like that, there's a reason everyone uses this. I think that's an awesome hop. Bizarre, and I'm out. Yeah.